In our second segment, we will be talking about, you know, the online course exhibition. Officially, this is the first batch which will come up in September 2020, which will be online, which is announced online and which will complete all its formalities in online mode. But before that, we have one batch, the current batch, you know, February 2020, which actually started in offline mode. I repeat once again, our last batch of February 2020, it started actually into offline mode. And then suddenly on, you know, 15th of March, we, because of this pandemic of COVID-19, we had to close the course. And then we thought of, we gave a lot of options to students whether to go online, and there are a lot of issues there. And fortunately, the batch has resumed now into online mode. Our last batch has resumed in online mode from 15th of July. So I think this batch is the right batch, right people to give us feedback on offline as well as in online, because this is the only batch which has seen both the modes. So I think we will go to our present batch students. I think everybody is in. Can you please switch on your videos, the current batch students? Others will go into the switch off mode, our mic as well as our videos. We all will go at the background now. And the current batch students, yeah, I think their feedback is most important. And purposely, we have kept a GD with them, that is online training versus offline training. Yeah. I would request, if the batch is ready, we can start our GD with them.
Hello everyone, myself Dushyant. I am from PGDBDA batch. And I want to say that there is no difference in online and offline as I have observed. And I want to say one thing more, that in online learning, various things has been overcome which we didn't have to be do in offline learning. Here we are doing course simultaneously with the faculty in the lecture. Whereas in the offline mode, where the faculty only have to deliver the lecture and we have to practice all the classwork in the lab time. But here, simultaneously the faculty is doing his or her code, and simultaneously we are having a code sharing utility. So here we can copy the code, we can see the code, and we can run the code with the sir. And if any student occurs any problem, so sir at that point, at that instant, solve the problem. We don't have to wait that in the lab time we are going to solve the code and solve the classwork, and then we are going to ask our difficulties. And this benefits us in that during lab time we are getting more assignments and we are getting more confidence on our coding control.
My name is Sachin. I'm also from the DBDA course, Feb 2020 batch. At the start, at Sir said, we started with the offline course. First 1.5 months, we did the offline course. And then due to lockdown, we shifted to the online mode. When online mode started, we guys also confused that we should join the online mode or we should wait till the course will start in offline mode or such that. Then we discussed some points and with the Nitin sir also. Then there are multiple pros in the online mode than the offline mode, I would say. We got the recorded sessions of all the lectures. Even if we have missed any points due to network issue or we have any doubt which is not clear in the session, then we can revisit our lectures and we can clear our doubts. Then the second thing I would say, the Zoom channel which have started in the online mode. We can interact with the faculty anytime we want. We can clear our doubts with the lab faculty. And there is a facility of having an individual chat with our friends as well. So in few days back, me and one of my friends are doing the assessment of our assignment. We are cross-checking the answers and clearing each other doubts. So our Zoom accounts, all of our students, is under the license of Sunbeam. So Nitin sir can join the meeting anytime he want. And then me and my friend were discussing, then Nitin sir joined the meeting and he asked, कौन किसको सिखा रहा है एंड ऑल. फिर सर सर ओके ओके गुड कीप इट अप एंड लाइक सो एंड इट वॉज अबाउट एट नाइट 9:30 10 o'clock. सो इट्स देर इज नो टाइम बैरियर इन द ऑनलाइन लर्निंग. आई वुड से इट्स लाइक इन अ फिजिकल मोड 8 to 8 वॉज द क्लासेस एंड आफ्टर 8 वी गो टू अवर हॉस्टल एंड वी आर टायर्ड एंड देन the communication between the faculty is in the time limit. Then in the online mode, there is no time barrier. And about the extracurricular activity, I would say in the last few weeks, we are having the HR interaction with the Priya ma'am itself. She introduced herself in this meeting. She took us various sessions of us like TEDx to communicate through the online mode, to build the confidence to talk in online mode. So they are very useful for us to build the confidence and to present ourselves in the online platform. So Sunbeam is taking lots of efforts to make this online learning very easy and very fruitful for us. Thank you.
Okay. Hello, everyone. I hope I'm audible, sir.
Yes.
Yeah. My name is Vibha Kumari. I'm from DMC batch, current February 2020 batch. I want to say all of you, I have experienced both online and offline courses of Sunbeam. I can say that in online batch, the communication between the student to student, every individual is more compared to offline batches. Here, we can say the time management and the cost management is also reduced so much. We can increase our productivity towards our work. It's very important. In online batch, we can say that we have lot of scenarios which company is working, and we are implementing on that scenario because of Sunbeam. Sunbeam is doing the same thing. They will provide us a good service. Either the staff is available for you 24/7. If you are feeling low, if you have a lack of self confidence, they will communicate with you. They will tell you you have problem in this area, and you have to tackle it that. So I believe that it's very important. Only the thing is that you have an avid towards learning and enthusiastic. So that's it from my side.
Good morning, everyone. I want to tell my experience with the Sunbeam. Being placed is a thing. We all know that we want to be placed, but being placed with the excellence and discipline is one of the best thing that will make us success. And being in a Sunbeam, it is being discussed that we are in a strict format right now, and it is very important to show ourselves with the confidence that yeah, we are following some disciplines right now. Okay, so apart from the technical knowledge, I want to share that Sunbeam is having a group activity in 2 or 3 days every day for us. That brings our confidence, or that is so fruitful that we every day we get to learn something new from it. So that is what I want to add up with that.
From my side, I'd like to tell you guys that when we started our course at Sunbeam in the initial days, we were so happy that we are using every second of our time and being more productive, learning more and more things. And when this pandemic happened, we were all so worried that what will happen to our lab sessions and our online sessions will be there. Will it be more fruitful? How things are going to be? But rest assured, guys, Sunbeam has taken care of everything. As my friends from the current batch said, there are different pros and cons of everything. But one thing that I have observed in Sunbeam that they pick those pros, they pick those cons, and they amplify those pros and try to mitigate those cons. We have a machine in front of us where we are watching videos of our teacher. And what else we can do with it? Like, why don't we code? This facility is not available in physical lectures. We are just watching him, and when we are going to the lab, then we are spending more time to chew it, right? So in this case, we are on the go, trying to solve our problems. We can share our screen, and we can ask our teacher that this is my doubt and I'm not able to solve it, and he'll help you. And on one more thing, in physical batch, I was having interactions with not more than 4 people. The guy who's sitting next to me, sitting in front of me, back of me, but that's it. But during this online, because of this Zoom and these Zoom channels, we are able to interact in our group as well, also intergroup as well. And we are having more, when there is the code, there are different algorithms, and we are able to touch different ideas as well. So this is more beneficial, I think. And about extracurricular activities, strictness and all, these things are very important, as pointed out by other people as well. So I'd like to tell you that if you are a team player, you'll be a better team player if you go through those activities. If you are a lead, you are having leadership qualities, you will be a better leader. So these things are designed in such a way that if you are kind of a circle, you will be a better circle. If you are kind of a square, you will be a better square. So these things are taken care of Sandeep to its best. No one else can, I think, do this. So that's it from my side, and all the best, guys.
One more point I would like to add. Sunbeam, we can give a Sunbeam a tag anywhere, anytime, accessibility for anything. Like if we want to help from the faculties at 9 p.m., 10 p.m., we can call anytime and they will solve our problem at that point only. Being in a physical batch, it was restricted by 8 p.m. only. But here we can talk to them at any time, and it also provides us a very greater work-life balance with the family, with the education and with the whole daily life routine.
My name is Divyanshi Verma and I am enrolled in a DAC Sunbeam Karar. I totally agree with all my fellow mates. I just want to add some point. Initially, I was also scared in the beginning that how this course, which is supposed to be a practical oriented, can be virtually. But after some time, I realized that the virtual platform is better than, because if you have any doubt in any topics, you can revise it after again and again, because recorded sessions and the faculty and the lab faculty which are available for you at any time. I mean, we can call them via Zoom in any time. The other most important feature that we have got is a proctored platform. It is a platform for the student provided for taking exam in online mode. As we know that the upcoming placement exam of all the industry and companies will take over our exam in this online platform. So Sunbeam has already laid a foundation for us for this virtual platform. Third point I just want to add, mostly students like me who travel thousands of kilometers from away from the parents, the virtual session has a big boom. I have a time to spend with my family and then there is a no feeling of homesickness. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Nivedita Tamrakar and I'm from the DMC course. I would also add one of my point of view. I'm completely agree with all of my friends that we are in the same situation and facing the same experiences. I just want to add one more thing, that we are actually learning the adaptability because our Sunbeam faculty is so much supportive that they try to make ourselves as much as comfortable they can. Initially, we were not comfortable. We were worried that how it would be possible in virtual mode, but they just given all their best input they can do. For example, they added a code sharing utility so that we can simultaneously code with our teacher also. So in this way, I can say they are giving all the possible best thing to us, which we are expecting to them, even which we needed to them. I think that is really great.
Yes. I just want to add one more point that as all are having a question regarding to the extra activities that as my friend Sashi has also said that we are having a session with HR PM ma'am. She is also in the meeting and we are having various interaction with the HR ma'am, and as a student having that, can we do any culture activities online or not, because we have seen main activities in offline mode only. As I want to say one thing more, that I am was the chairman of my college and I have conduct various events in offline mode, but just the thing of the yesterday there was a teacher's day, and our last session with the piano also, we have conducted our first virtual online cultural program, and you can also take a feedback from piano that it was really very good. And we were just not having such hope that this program will go into such a wonderful and successful. And the thing that the students are having interest in dancing, singing, and art and craft, even cooking. So Sunbeam conducts these all activities in 6 months, including they complete all technical stuff in 6 months, including your projects and preparation for placement, aptitude, each and everything. That's from my side, and good luck to all of you. Thank you.
we'll take a last question or last point from Saddam and then we'll stop here. Yeah, yes, Saddam.
Yeah, for the people who were asking questions like, it's a technical course, why we need such kind of extracurricular activities and all. But to those people, we were thinking the same, okay. But when we went through that activity, the first activity was the cricket. But we, in offline mode, we were doing that and I sensed a kind of unity in our group. And there were different people who were performing role of leaders, different people were helping them, like team players. So these things are not just to like make your mood light. There are hidden agendas behind it, I think. Like to make yourself a better professional as well. These things will help you. Like being a team player, being a leader, these kind of things are also going to help you. So these things are very important. And at the same time, like we were having this hot seat activity, talks with HRs. These things improve your confidence. So these things are also important. That was I felt going through all these activities. So don't worry about that and just submit your will to Sunbeam, I think. And rest is assured. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any questions from HR side to students, current best students?
I was keen to ask one thing just. But I think a part of it has already been answered. But still, I would ask them. Do you guys miss the fun of the class? दो लोग बैठे हैं, तीन लोग बैठे हैं और आपस में जो मस्ती चलती है, जहाँ पे टीचर्स इन्वॉल्व नहीं होते हैं, जहाँ पे सिर्फ स्टूडेंट्स होते हैं, ठीक है, और वो टीचर उधर पीछे घूमे तो पीछे जो मजे चलते हैं, बिकॉज somebody right now said कि नितिन सर has an access to all the Zoom channels, तो वो मस्ती चलती कैसे?
Actually, sir, yes, we do miss it. When there was this video going on at the start, okay, me and Diksha were chatting on WhatsApp, like, oh my goodness, we missed those classrooms and those lobby and all those things. And it was kind of a nostalgia that we were going through. Right, it hasn't been that much of long time, but still we were like missing those days. But yes, it's not like that. Nitin sir is not going to pop up in every meeting. So we do that on something as well. So, it's fun.
WhatsApp has taken the place of backbench, right?
Yeah.
Along with online training, you are also chatting on WhatsApp.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
That video was so emotional.
Yes. Sorry, Diksha, complete, yeah.
So that video was so emotional that I just took the WhatsApp and messaged Saddam that I'm really missing the physical batch right now, watching that gallery and that girls' hostel and that mess. So that is why we were just having a short conversation on that. But in online mode also, me and Saddam have talked in night, having the regards with the problem with the codes also, and have some little chat at that time. It's not that we are just bonded with the education and only that way. We have friends in online mode also.
Prashant ji, ye sab log engineers
hai. I realized it later on.
इंजीनियर्स का एक होता है सब जुगाड़ू रहते हैं, कुछ भी कर सकते हैं.
Exactly. नहीं वो इंजीनियर्स का नहीं, इंडियंस का रहता है, कहीं भी होंगे जुगाड़ कर लेंगे वो. अब आपको सिर्फ ये करना है कि हर एक मीटिंग में ना जाओ.
निशान जी, मैं भी इंसान और बच्चों के लिए जाता हूँ, आप यू नो.
नहीं, हम भी बच्चों के लिए आते हैं, थोड़ा बहुत छोड़ देना चाहिए.
थैंक यू, इट वॉज नाइस इंटरेक्शन. या थैंक्स. We can quickly go to, of course, we have our next panel ready with us. We have our senior members, our technical director, Nilesh sir, with us. We also have our another director from technical background, Amit Kulkarni sir. These people will explain about how we will be executing the course in online mode. Aur shayad bahut logo ko pata hai, jo log Sunbeam mein kafi saal se associated hai, that Sunbeam mein har koi teacher hai. Sunbeam mein our chairman and managing director is teacher. Myself, I am also technical background. I have taught for 15 to 16 years. You know, till our last, even person from accounts background, he also teaches tally. You'll not believe. And hum logon ne culture kyu kiya hai? Because so that we understand the student's problem. A teacher can understand the student's problem. So that is why we have an orientation that everybody is a teacher, coming with a teacher, hey, so that we can understand. So, over to you, our technical directors, Nilesh sir and Amit sir, to explain our execution plan for the next batch.
Myself, Nilesh Gulen. And first of all, I'll really congratulate you since you people have qualified for your CCAT exam. And I'm very sure you must be looking for doing online batch starting from September end, right? I'm very sure the kind of question you must be having, you know, in your mind, talking about, will I be really able to learn in online mode? Obviously, you must have seen, you know, the answers of our HR experts, our seniors, or even for that sake, our current batch students, correct? But you just see around, you know, you find that nowadays even kids are learning online, guys. You see, find that literally the KG students, they are attending, you know, Microsoft Teams or like Google Hangouts or whatnot, you know, depending on their schools, it is going on. So what is the problem with the higher education? Higher education, yes, it is very much possible. And that too, don't you think that we are right now in information technology? So information technology, there is absolutely no issue that we can learn in online mode. The question might have in your mind that, but sir, can you teach online? You know, that is the reason I'm here. Let me tell you guys, just to give you like a brief idea, we come, stopped Sunbeam activities on like 14th of March due to the corona pandemic. And, you know, by around, we spend next 2-3 days just finding out which all good platforms are available online. Literally, me and my whole team, we have literally researched like every platform that is available. We purchased our first license of a Zoom account on like 16th of March. And probably by 18th of March, we started conducting the sessions in online mode. So it was hardly like 3 to 4 days of time. And trust me, next, it took hardly couple of weeks, or not even couple of weeks, couple of days more, you can say, where we start polishing the skills in like online mode. I'm very sure many of the students, you know, they have done pre-CAT course with us. They can very well relate, and they find that, you know, many of the things that we need, we already had it available, or like some refinement we need, we have done it like, you know, a very short span of time. Let me just tell you guys, we started teaching our PG courses immediately. As we go ahead, we thought of why not opening up like again modular courses, going with like a weekend batches once again, something that we have stopped. Some of the corporate trainings were there in line. Let me tell you, we taught around 43 online batches apart from our full-time courses were there. And you must have seen more than 3,000 participants were there. What these participants were, please understand that few of them, they were like, you know, college going students. Few of them like, you know, job seekers, like absolute freshers, and few of them were experienced. I had got, you know, few of my students, you must have seen like Sarthak or like some others. So they are actually working even at the post of like a solution architect or like that. And then even having after, you know, 10, 15 years of experience, they love to come back to the Sunbeam and again, you know, revise their basics or probably discuss their real project problems and all that. We literally taught, you know, every simple technology to even most complicated one. We taught data structures to enterprise Java. We talk about DevOps to machine learning. We even taught, you know, device drivers, Linux device drivers module in like online mode into this. So guys, I can assure you, me and my whole team, it is very much geared up for this online training. Let me just quickly brief you what you see into the DAC course or like mobile computing course. So usually, you know, every batch that start with, we usually start with like kind of a bit of C programming, where we revise some of the programming fundamentals for a week or so and try to get students once again into the programming zone, a quick revision, and then we proceed for the next. If you really take a look at the DAC course, you'll find that the programming fundamentals or like data structures and operating system along with Linux, these are some modules that will build foundations which will help you for the rest of the course. And the rest of the course, you find that DAC is a diploma in advanced computing course. So what is advanced computing course? It is all about making enterprise grade applications. And enterprise grade application, nowadays you go to the recruitment and companies have got a requirement saying that they are looking for full stack developer. And people are asking, oh sir, what is full stack developer? Full stack developer is one, you know, who can make database, who can write like business logic, who can prepare kind of front end, and not only that, even deploy the application. So complete end to end flow. And good thing is that, you know, DAC course really covers everything. So it has got database module, RDBMS, NoSQL introduction, and we have got two full stack development stacks over there. So one is Java stack, talking about core Java, talking about advanced Java, and then Spring, Hibernate, or even Spring Boot, right? Which is right now used in industry. And the second stack, which is nowadays becoming more popular over the period. So you talk about a MERN stack, where we talk about Node.js, where we talk about React.js, where we talk about, you know, Express, and so on and so forth. So you find that these two stacks, which are very common nowadays for the recruitment companies, you know, they have, we have got included into the course. Obviously, all our full-time courses end with the project, and at Sunbeam, you know, our experience really helped us. We follow the software engineering principles, we follow the agile techniques, we try to group the students and try to, you know, assign a task. And over the period, I'm very sure even our, some of the students of even current batch, you know, they are already gearing up using Git and all that kind of code versioning systems right now, before even we start with the project in a full-blown way. So yes, DAC course is very common. Everyone is aware of it. Usually the second thing, probably the mobile computing course I will talk about, I have seen that bit less students, you know, are aware of mobile computing. Reason might be there are less number of students all over India for the mobile computing domain, correct? If you really able to compare, you know, purposefully we have just arranged the all topics, you know, side by side mode, so that you can find that mobile computing course, we have got everything that DAC course has got. I would even say that we always say that this course is like a DAC plus plus course. So DAC plus plus course. So what extra that we have got? So you find that we have got data structure, we have got operating system, we have got databases, we have got complete Java development, we have got React and like MERN development. Yes, we are covering almost everything. But additionally, we also teach mobile programming, we teach Android programming, we teach hybrid programming stack. And that is the reason, if you have really gone through the, you know, our placement slides or even packages slide of the DMC course, you'll find that the DMC course placements, usually you might find that it is very much consistent, you know, 100%, 95% or something like that over the last 5 years. And obviously the last batch placement, they are still on, things are going on. Eventually that will be also catch up. You can even find out the even average package of the DMC course is, you know, much better as compared to, you know, you compare with like other courses. So you'll find that it is still in a good range. I'm hoping that, you know, this information regarding DAC course, DMC course will definitely help you to choose the course at your end. Definitely, I'll pass on the baton to the Amit Kulkarni sir, where he will tell you about Big Data course and he will tell you about how we really conduct our courses at Sunbeam. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Nilesh sir, and thank you, Nitin sir. First of all, good afternoon all. I hope I am audible. The first thing, before I talk about the DBDA course and before I talk about the online education system, let me ask a quick question. Now, I know there is a pandemic everywhere and you guys cannot move out of your home. You might probably sitting at your home from a couple of months. You might be feeling boring. And just to take a maybe a refreshment, you might have seen a couple of movies. Maybe when you talk about the movies, Netflix is the best platform these days. I bet you might have seen at least a couple of movies on Netflix. Or if you're too studious to watch a movie, then you might have even ordered some items from or some products from Amazon. Did you see some things which are common to these websites these days? You might have seen that if you go to Netflix and try to watch a movie, Netflix will suggest you something. Like these many people have watched this movie. You just go ahead and watch this. You definitely will like it. When you are going on a website like Amazon, the Amazon will try to suggest you, okay, these people have purchased this product, you might like it. Haven't you noticed that? Everywhere, people are suggesting you something so that you can save some time. So basically, earlier, I literally have to go through the entire movie catalog just to choose a nice movie. But these days, I don't have to. I just open my Netflix movie and I get some recommendations. And believe me or not, most of the times, the recommendations really work. I'm a movie buff. I know how many movies I watch. So I can tell you from my own experience, this holds true. Now, if you have had this experience in the first time, now you might be wondering, like, how is it possible for these guys just to tell us something about ourselves? There is no secret, guys. This is done by using a concept called as machine learning. So these days, machine learning is everywhere. I mean, even though you know it or you don't know about it, you still are using machine learning from some of the other ways. Couple of examples I give you, like the Netflix or the Amazon or the Flipkart. There are n number of sites where you'll find it integrated these days. So machine learning is a kind of a concept which is kind of in boom in the industry. And definitely if you are learning machine learning, then probably you will be also finding yourself in a good position. Now, a couple of questions from your makeup. Like, if I want to learn machine learning, what are different things that I need to know? Any technology will want you to have at least one programming language. The good thing about machine learning here is like you can have a couple of languages available, but the best language to go for machine learning is Python. Python being the simplest language, and it is the language which can be used anywhere, be it a machine learning, be it a console application, be it a GUI application. You can think of any type of application and you can develop that using Python. So in this course, DBDA, we are going to start learning the Python. Python, as I said, it's a popular language. We are going to use this Python and we are going to tune it for machine learning. Now, when you are going for Python, the machine learning, Python plus machine learning, there is one special language. I mean, other than Python, you can also use something called as R. R is a specially designed statistical language, which is also another popular language you can use for machine learning. So when you talk about a machine learning, there are a few foundation stuff that you will learn in DBDA course. In this course, you will learn how to use Python for doing something called as data visualization. You might have seen you have got maybe so much of data in your databases, but unless you understand the data, you'll not be able to do anything. Let's take a quick example of that Netflix. Netflix gives me a suggestion because Netflix understands me. Netflix hasn't seen me or Netflix doesn't know me personally, but Netflix knows my data. Netflix knows how many movies I've watched earlier, and based on that, Netflix can suggest something. This is generally called as a data analysis. So in this course, you are going to learn something called as a data analysis. Sometimes only analytics will not help. After analysis, you will go for you will go over what has happened earlier and you want to rectify or you want to fine tune it. This is generally called as analytics. So here you will learn the data analysis and the data analytics as well. Now to do something like this, you need to store a huge amount of data. And believe me, when you talk about Netflix or Amazon or Flipkart, they are having not billions, they are having trillion products, or their database is not in terabytes. The database has gone to something called as a petabytes. Petabyte is almost 1024 terabytes. So they are using the database of petabytes. And if you are using the database at this scale, you need a big data. And that's where again, you are going to learn different big data technologies here. Now to do this big data or to use this something like a machine learning, you again will need a kind of a platform. You again will need a kind of a foundation. That foundation is none other than Linux. Linux is everywhere. I mean, Windows you might have seen earlier, but Linux is the future. Sooner or later, many companies, they already have changed their environment from Windows to Linux, but sooner or later, almost every company is going with the Linux. Being it's open source, being it's free, you will not have to pay any license cost to anyone. That's the reason Linux is popular, and you are going to learn complete Linux administration in this course. This course will tell you like what exactly a hello, maybe an echo command, echo hello command to start from it, and we are going to go with the advanced Linux administration. This will give you confidence about how to use your machine, how to use your machine effectively to do all these kind of stuff. Now, apart from that, if you want to go to company, you'll have to pass some aptitude related questions. Of course, the aptitude is also there. And once you are kind of gone through all the technologies, all the different modules, you have to see how much knowledge you have got. There's only one thing that will give you the confidence and that will give you a kind of, or you can testify your knowledge, is nothing but the project. So like DAC, like DMC, DBDA also has a project. Now in this case, we are going for a couple of different projects. Like there'll be a small project, we generally call it as a mini project, that will give you a kind of boosting about your knowledge on particular topic or particular module. And towards the end of entire course, you are going to develop the entire project. That will be a kind of course project, which will have all the different technologies in it. That will give you again the boost to learn the knowledge or to learn whatever you have learned so far from the practical or from the real life examples. These projects will again tell you how these technologies can be used in the real world. So this is all about the DBDA course. Now, when you talk about the DBDA course or when you talk about DMC or DAC, you might be having some questions in your mind. Shansa, can you please go to the next slide, please? Yeah, you might be having some questions in your mind. Like if you want to go for online course, then what will be the timing or how the course will be conducted? Will I be able to write the code there directly with the faculty? Or will I be able to ask the questions? Will I be able to finish my assignments? Or will I be able to give the exam in online mode? So let me answer a few of the questions here. Because you are learning this in online mode, this timing is completely flexible. I mean, as many of us already have said that, there are pros and cons of offline and online. Being online, you will get a flexibility, time flexibility. Of course, the course timing will be 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., but sometimes you will have the lectures in the morning, practical in the afternoon, or maybe you will have the practical in the morning or lectures in the afternoon. It will be flexible. But every day, there will be a kind of lecture and there will be kind of practical. Unless you practice, you will not get the confidence. And to go for the practice, of course, we will have the entire 4 to 5 SL sessions. Of course, that will be broken in a couple of different chunks. But throughout the day, there will be sessions on theoretical topics and there'll be completely practical sessions reserved for doing the practice on whatever topics you have learned on that day. Coming back to the rest sessions, for example, if I'm delivering a session like now and if I'm writing a code, because you will be developer sooner or later, you will have to have that confidence, like you can write the code. So if you want to write the code along with me, we as a Sunbeam team, we already have developed a small utility. We call it as a code sharing utility. This code sharing utility will give you a kind of a screen where whatever code the faculty is typing on his machine, you will be able to see that code in real time. For example, if I type echo hello and if I press enter and if I save, then automatically that line will appear on your machine. You can simply copy and paste it on your machine and probably you can try that on your machine and see whether it is working or not. That will give you confidence that whatever code the faculty is writing and whatever code the working on faculty's machine is also working on your machine. Of course, if you are smart enough, you will write the code on your own. This is a kind of helping utility that will give you a kind of, you know, the time saving so that instead of typing the code in the session time, copy paste and see whether it is working and move to the next point. Now, when you are doing this theoretical point, of course, we will write the code. You will also write the code. But ultimately, if you want to get more confidence about what you have learned, you have to solve the assignments. That's where in the second half of the day, you will have some lab assignments. In the lab timing, you'll be given some assignments that will have some practical knowledge that will give you the practical knowledge and that will also give you a kind of exposure to how the topic can be used in the real world. So of course, we'll have to solve the assignments. You have to submit the answers and get them completed. Apart from that, there will be weekly quizzes every Friday or maybe the timing will be decided as per all of our convenience, but there'll be weekly quizzes. Again, quiz is another way to testify whatever you have learned, whether have you understood it fully or not. So that will again give you a boost to understand the technology in a better way. Now, as I mentioned earlier, like the other courses, we are also having the mini project, not only for DBDA, it is true for all the different courses there. For example, if you are developing a mean application or an Angular application to be precise, you will develop a small project only on the Angular just to get the confidence on that technology. Over the period, once you learn all the different technologies, you will combine them and you will finish the entire project for your course in. But there will be some mini projects in between that will give you a kind of confidence on the technologies on the modules you are learning. There will be lab exams as well. Those lab exams are proctored in a sense. You will sit on your machine. You will be presented with the question paper. You will have to answer that or you have to code that. The person on the other end, lab mentors and the staff member will be watching you to see whether you are doing it or you are not cheating with us or you are doing it good. So all the lab exams will be proctored. Now, working in online will have some cons as well. So probably when you are sitting at home, and of course it happens a lot. I mean, when you go to offline, you'll be completely focused completely for 4 hours without having any disturbance. But when you are sitting at home and when you are attending the session, it might happen that your family member will call you or maybe you will get a phone call. And because there is no restrictions around you, you might pick up the phone and you go in the different context. By the time you're talking to that person, you will lose a couple of points. It may happen. And I already have observed after conducting so many batches online. So it may happen. sometimes, again, even if you're too studious and even if you're completely locked yourself in a room to focus completely on the session, it might happen that your internet connection is kind of fluctuating, it's kind of acting. So you might lose some of the points there. It might happen. So what we have done here is, whenever we are conducting sessions, we are always recording those sessions. I know, and this is a kind of well-known fact, that when you are using online courses, you cannot guarantee about the internet. You cannot dependent on the network, because network is something which we are kind of dependent on the other service providers. So we cannot guarantee that. So to avoid these kind of network fluctuation or these kind of scenarios, we always record our sessions. All the recorded sessions will be available on the very, very same day. So after a couple of hours, you finish the session, the lecture will be available. We have developed something called a student portal, where you log in, you create your account, and you get all these things there. You will go for your weekly quizzes in the same portal. You will also find the lecture recording there, and you can also see how many marks you have got and how much progress you have made. So this entire portal is developed in-house by Sunbeam team, and the Sunbeam portal will give you enough information about what exactly you are doing or where you are directing right, or where your directions are right now. Now, when you are going for these kind of online courses, there are some prerequisites. The prerequisite is nothing but, the main prerequisite is nothing but your laptop or your desktop. You should have a nice configuration of a laptop or a desktop, whichever you choose, but make sure that it is having a nice configuration, at least a decent configuration. I'm not looking for high end, but at least a decent configuration is required, so that you can write the code along with us, and also you can practice it without having any problem, without having any machine related problem. The main thing being an online course here is, like, you are going to attend that course using your internet connection. So again, a good quality of internet connection is must. I mean, it said that earlier there were only three basic necessities. I think these days the definition is changed. There are four basic necessities. Other than these three, internet or network has become the fourth basic necessity. And that's the reason why, again, you should have a decent internet connection in order to, attend these online courses, online sessions. And finally, you should have a right attitude to learn something new. Believe me, when you are going for these kind of courses, you will get even more than the offline course. I mean, I am surprised that people generally come from online to offline just to avoid these kind of issues. But when we started with this online, people appreciated that we came from offline to online, because they could write the code along with us. They could ask the questions directly on the spot, and we could rectify the problems, and people were getting benefited there. By the time we are finishing the sessions, people were already having enough knowledge to go for the practical and to solve the lab assignments, those assignments which are on the real life examples or real life situations. So with that said, I think this entire kind of discussion would have given you enough information about the course DBDA, and it must have given you a quick introduction to how we as a Sunbeam team conducting this course in an online way. Thank you very much. I'm passing it on to Nitin sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Amit sir. Most of the questions from the students, they are already answered. We can just quickly go through some slides just to check whether we have answered the questions or not. And if some questions are not answered, we can definitely take it. We have a poll. We have given enough information. We can quickly launch our poll and take up some feedback from the students. We can go to the next question, which we can see. I think online learning, what are the challenges and advantages of online learning? Challenges are, of course, we need to have a lot of concentration because in online learning, we're at home. So there must be some family disturbances. So that is one of the challenge. Second challenge is, of course, arranging internet. There's another challenge. Having a laptop, our own laptop or desktop, shouldn't be a problem. We know engineering students, 90% of students, they have their own laptops. But if not, that can be arranged, because that can be also used after the course. So challenges, yes, motivation is very important. Self-motivation is very important. Right attitude is important. And acceptance of this online learning is another challenge that is to be sorted out. As for the advantages are concerned of online learning, advantage of online learning, one thing is saying the cost. Let me tell you, the cost of the physical batch is to be 2 lakh rupees. I'll repeat once again, this is an important factor. In physical batch, the cost of the course to the student at the end, lodging, boarding, traveling, other things, and course fees. So all of that I'm close to 2 lakh rupees. I would have just come down to 50,000 rupees plus GST. So we'll be saving a cost, lot of cost. One thing. Second thing is safety. Current pandemic situation is not allowing anybody to come out, or advisor also. So this is the best time to learn. So cost is another factor. Yeah, and there's a biggest advantage of online learning. Flexibility is another one. So I think this also we have covered this question.